Hi, in this tutorial I will give an overview of serial communication in Arduino, and we'll focus on how to use this serial monitor and the serial plotter within the Arduino programming environment. So this is the context of this tutorial. First, a short introduction to serial communication and how to use it within Arduino. And both the serial monitor and the serial plotter is nice to use, since the Arduino programs in general has no graphical user interface. So I will give an overview of the serial monitor and how to use it, and how to create program to see values within the serial monitor, and the same for the serial plotter. Then I will show how to use both the serial monitor and the serial plotter to send serial data. Typically, most users use the serial monitor and the serial plotter to view data, but you can also use these tools to send data to your Arduino program. So you can update variables, etc., using either the serial monitor and serial plotter and the send serial data features within these tools. I will also provide lots of examples. So basically, that's the contents of this tutorial. So then let's start with some basic serial communication with Arduino. First, short introduction to Arduino for those who haven't used Arduino before. So Arduino is a microcontroller, and Arduino is an open source platform with input and output pins, which you see here. Here you see an Arduino Uno. So you have pins on top here and in the bottom that you can use to interface different types of sensors, etc. It's a quite cheap component or device, about $20 or something. And here you see how you configure or set up the Arduino. So you have the Arduino device. You can have different sensors that you connect to these different pins. And then you connect to your computer. So you create your Arduino programs on your computer with the Arduino integrated development environment. And then you connect your computer to the Arduino device using an ordinary USB cable. And then you upload the code you create here on your computer and upload it to the Arduino device. And basically, when you create an Arduino program here and upload it to the Arduino, you can unplug the cable and then the Arduino program will run without the computer. But since this tutorial is about serial communication, we need to have this cable plugged in between the computer and the Arduino at all time, because we'll use the PC to create some different types of graphical user interfaces for this Arduino code that is running on the Arduino device. So here you see the Arduino programming environment. So you use this programming environment to create your Arduino code, and then later we will use LabVIEW to interface with this these programs you create here using serial communication, because all Arduino programs, you create them here and then you upload them to the Arduino hardware, and then there are no graphical user interface, so just code running in the back. Also here on the upper right corner you can see this button in order to open the built-in serial monitor. So serial communication in Arduino, we start the serial communication using the serial.begin, and then we type a baud rate here in bits per second, typically 9600. So then we use this command in order to open the communication with the serial port, and then we use either serial.print, and then here we can type either a text or a variable or just a number. And also we have something called serial.println. The difference between those, when you use println, you create a new line, and when you use serial print or print line next time, then the text or the number will start on a new blank line. That's the basic functions that you need in order to use serial communication within Arduino. So let's start with this basic example. So here you see a basic Arduino program. So all Arduino program consists of a function called setup. So here you set up all the initial parts, and then you have the main loop. So typically you use this serial.begin in the setup function, and then you use either serial.print or serial.println within the main loop. So this basic program just start the communication with the serial port and then print the value of x, which is in the beginning equal to 0, print it to the serial port, and then you can open either the serial monitor or the serial plotter in order to see the value. And then within this loop, I increase the value of x with 1, so and also have a delay here of 1000 milliseconds, and in the next iteration, serial print x will be 1, and in the next iteration it will be 2, 3, 4, etc. So then let's see how we can use the serial monitor in order to monitor this variable x. So here you see the Arduino environment, and we just click on this button in order to open the serial monitor. So here you see our first example. So let's start creating this first example and then see how we can use the serial monitor in this case. So we start with this basic example. So here you have the Arduino environment, and here I have created the basic Arduino example where I use this serial.begin in the setup, and then I have declared a variable here, and in the main loop I create or write serial.print x, and then I increase the variable x with 1 in each iteration, and then I have a delay. So let's just run this example or upload it to the Arduino hardware, clicking this upload button, and then in the meantime we can open the serial monitor, which you find here or in this button. So now it's done uploading, and you see first is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, etc. So this is happen when I'm using the print. If I change it to print line like this, and upload the code once more and open the serial monitor. And then you see 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. And so each number starts on a new line because I'm using this print line instead of just print. So basically, this is the basic feature of how you can communicate with the serial port and then use this serial monitor. So let's see if you can use this serial plotter instead. So the serial plotter actually plots the value in a plot like this. So as you see, the number x is increasing by 1 in each second, like this. So in order to use the serial plotter, I need to use this print line. If I go back to just typing print, it will not work. So now, like this, upload this code again, and then use the serial plotter, and now you will see no results here because it will only plot when you use this print line command. So now I have updated the example, have created a bit more advanced example. Now I have two variables, x and y, and then I have used a built-in function for finding the sign. So then I will find sine of x and put it into variable y, and then I will print the variable y for different values of x. And then in each iteration I have a delay. So let's just upload this code and see how it looks like in the serial monitor. So now it's uploading, finish upload, and then you see the values for y are printed here to the serial monitor. And let's see how it looks like in the serial plotter. You see, you will get a sine curve here using the serial plotter like this. In this example, I have modified the previous example, so now I'm going to print both y equals to sine of x and then y equals to cosinus of x like this. So then just upload this example, and then start by watching the serial monitor. And then you see the first column here is sine, and the second column is cosinus. And so here I'm using serial.print for this y, and then I use serial.print and this tabulator. So there's, you see, there's a tab between the two columns here, and then for the y I use print line. So here I use print, print, and print line. So after this one line, there will be a new line and in the next iteration. So this is how it works in the serial monitor. So let's open the serial plotter for this example. As you see here now, it will plot two variables, namely sine of x and cosinus of x. So the blue one is sine of x and the red one is cosinus of x. And it will plot both. So in order to plot multiple variables in the serial plotter, you need to do it like this. So the first variable, use print, and then you need to separate the different variables using this tabulator's symbol, or just a space is also allowed. And then for the final variable, you need to use print line. So if you are printing three variables, you need to use this tabulator twice. So basically, this is how you use the serial monitor and the serial plotter within the within the Arduino environment. So now, so far, we have seen how we can use Arduino and the serial monitor and the serial plotter in order to write serial data, so you can see the values in within the serial monitor and the serial plotter. But we can also use these tools to send serial data. So here you see the serial monitor, and here on the top here you have a text field where you can actually write values, text, letters or numbers, and then click send, and these values will be sent to the serial port. And you can use your Arduino code in order to read this this information you send here. Either it's a string, a number, etc. So it will be some kind of a graphical interface that you have with your within your Arduino code. And also the same with the serial plotter. In the bottom of the serial plotter, you have a field here which you can enter text or numbers or characters, and then click the send button. So then this, both the serial monitor and the serial plotter will function as a basic graphical user interface for your Arduino code. So let's see some examples. So let's take a close look at this basic example. So here in this example, I'm writing to the serial monitor or the serial port, "Are you ready? Yes, no." So this is a question to the user, and then the user should either here in this text field above type either Y or N. And if he types Y, then the code responds with "Great, you are ready." If he type N for no, then the code responds with "Let me know when you're ready." So here you see the code. So we start with a variable of type char. I just call it input. And then in the setup, here I start the communication with the serial port using the serial.begin. And then I start printing to the serial monitor, serial.println. "Are you ready? Yes, no." So then this will be written to the serial monitor. And then in the main loop, I check if someone are writing values to the on the serial port. So then I use serial.available, and if there are some character available, meaning if this one is larger than zero, then you can start reading the values that are entered here in this field. So then I use input equals to, I convert it to a byte, use serial.read, and then this input variable will either have the value Y or N. And then if input equals to Y, then I print serial print line, "Great, you are ready." And else if the input equals to n, then I print 0 print line, let me know when you're ready. And then I wait for 100 milliseconds, and then this goes into a infinity loop like this. So let's run this program within a Arduino environment. So then I have the Arduino program ready here, as just explained. Then I just upload this code to the Arduino hardware, and then I go and open the serial monitor. And I just wait a few seconds until this code has been uploaded to the Arduino hardware. And now it's uploaded. And are you ready? Yes, no. And I type N and click either enter or click the send button. Let me know when you are ready. So now the code goes into here. It was finding a character on the serial port, and then it was starting serial read, and then this input was not equal to y, but it was equal to n. So then I was printing this text to the serial monitor. Let me know when you are ready. And let's type n once more. Let me know when you are ready. And then finally type y. Great, you are ready. So now zero print line. The input equals to y, and then I print 0 in print line. Great, you are ready, like this. So basically, this you can use this serial monitor as a very simple graphical user interface that are interfacing your Arduino program like this. Here you see another example. So in this basic example, it's almost identical. So you use this serial available, and you and something has been written to the serial port. I just read these characters or the values using serial.read. And now I'm checking if the input is either X or Y. And if it's X, I just create a random value between 0 and 10 and print it to the serial monitor. And if yes, I generate a random value between 20 and 30 and print it to the serial monitor like this. So let's just run this application, upload it to the Arduino hardware, and open the serial monitor like this. So now I will type either X or Y. Let's start with X. Then, so you see, it generates a random number between 0 and 10 like this. Let's type Y. Now you see it generates a random value between 20 and 30, like this. So then I can change either type X or Y. X or Y, like this. So basically, this is a simple graphical user interface that are interfacing with your Arduino code. I can also use the serial plotter in this case. So tools, serial plotter, and here in this text field, I can type either X or Y. So X generates a value between 1 and 10, like this, and Y generates a value between 20 and 30. So then I can change between X and Y like this, and each time a new value will be plotted here in this serial plotter like this.